a few days back, a friend of mine was visiting. वो मेरे साथ रह रही थी. शुरू में उनकी ट्रिप केवल दो दिन की थी, लेकिन फिर वो तीन दिन की हो गई. तो तीसरे दिन जब वो ऑफिस से वापस आई तो काफ़ी परेशान लग रही थी. सो आई आस्क्ड हर व्हाट हैपेंड. शी इज लाइक, मैं तीन ही कपड़े लेके आई थी और तीनों मैं पहन चुकी हूँ, और अब शाम को मुझे अपने दोस्तों से मिलने जाना है और मैं परेशान हूँ. सो आई टोल्ड हर, आई डोंट बी वॉश वन ऑफ योर आउटफिट्स एंड जस्ट आयरन इट क्विकली, यू कैन वेयर इट. शी इज लाइक, नहीं, रिपीट तो मैं कर ही नहीं सकती, फेसबुक पर पिक्चर्स आएंगी, इट विल बी वेरी वियर्ड. ऑप्शन टू, अब मेरे कपड़े ट्राई कर लो. सो वी ट्राइड wearing a couple of my clothes and she wasn't very happy because she said, ye pink mujh pe acha nahi lag raha hai, I'm a little dusky and this is making my arms look a little chubby. So eventually wo mall gayi and she bought a new dress for herself. So this whole incident just got me thinking that when did appearances become so important to us? When we were kids, it really didn't matter ki hum kya pehen ke ghar se bahar khelne ja rahe hain. What mattered was ki we're going to be meeting our friends. So at what point in life does it happen that we become so aware of the way we look? And with social media becoming such an integral part of our lives, this world is becoming more and more a confusing place. From Deepika Padukone's airport looks to Varun Dhawan's shoes, you have so many options and still trying to figure the real self out. This just got me thinking. Welcome to Fitting In, a show where you don't need to fit in. Today we have with us Kartik Athavale.
Hi.
So Kartik, if you were in the situation ki aap teen din ki trip pe aur aap teenon kapde pehen chuke hain, to aap kya karte?
I have absolutely no problems repeating clothes. So social media pe na meri shakal koi dekhna chahta hai, na main khud dikhana chahta hu zyada logon ko. So I'm perfectly fine with repeating clothes. Okay. That's all right.
But how much importance do you give as a person to appearances, to the clothes you wear?
My primary concern when I'm picking clothes is comfort.
Okay.
Obviously, there is a different level of comfort in different scenarios that you go through. So if I'm going for an evening, I don't want to look shabby, but I still want to be comfortable for the occasion, for the place that I'm going to. If I'm going to office, then kapde office worthy hone chahiye. That's the primary objective. And baki, if I'm just roaming around, I'm very comfortable in a pair of shorts and a t-shirt maybe.
Okay. So, but could you take us through like the evolution of your sense of style, so to say? Ab jab chote the, fir ek samay pe aake aapke kapde aapne khud choose karna shuru kiya hoga, and you must have figured out that okay, this is the kind of person I'm becoming, and how important a part of it was the way you dressed.
Sure. So, everyone goes through this journey of self-realization where clothing is concerned, and when you're young, your parents usually pick your clothes, which are usually more ridiculous than you could ever pick for yourself. So that's how my story also unfolded. So parents used to pick my clothes till about, I would say, 6th, 7th standard, post which I started getting a little more say in how I should run my life in terms of what apparel I pick for myself. But then we were also being in a 4G family, we moved around a lot, and mostly stayed in cantonments.
Okay.
So the environment used to have a good effect on what you wear and what you pick. Your options were limited in a lot of places, because when you're posted in places like Pathankot or Kapurthala or Lalgarh Jatta in Rajasthan, you don't really have shopper stops and all the fancy stores to go and purchase your clothes. So whatever the local market has to offer has to be done with.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever the best you can pick from there is what you end up wearing. And of course, at that point in time, there were only two or three different kinds of things that you could wear. One was your school uniform, which you really did not have any option with. The other was khelne ke liye kya pehen rahe ho, bahar friends se milne jaane ke liye. Aur friends se milne ke liye jaate bhi kahan the, wahan pe us time pe coffee shops and all this was not
concept
really
maker.
Something, yeah, which was very prevalent. So you'd go out to play. So it would basically be shorts or track pants and t-shirts and whatever.
So do you think relationships, maybe, like a romantic relationship or a relationship with your parents, they do impact the way you dress, the way
of
you
course,
dress yourself?
Of course. So I have seen this happen, and it has happened to me also, where the person you're in a relationship, whether it's a girlfriend, a boyfriend, or your parents, or a very close friend, they influence what you wear a lot. So, girls usually don't like you wearing baggy clothes at all. They want you
okay.
to look smart because you're their boyfriend. So.
Another interesting thing that I tend to ask all my male guests is, what do you think about color stereotypes and stuff like pink? Maybe not a lot of men are comfortable with.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure if they've even tried pastel shades or not. So do you think that, one, they exist, these stereotypes? And if yes, then how do you feel about
it? So yes, in the society, stereotypes definitely do exist. But when you're out there in the world, you actually see people breaking these stereotypes left, right and center. While they get criticized and judged a lot, but they're still out there doing it, and if they're confident doing it, I think they should go for it. Like I was saying, you know, in my college also, wearing white trousers and pink satin and silk shirts and, you know, with all sorts of designs going on around it, people used to wear that and they used to flaunt it like, you know, because it was the best thing that they could have worn for the day.
Do you think these people keep telling you, kaise ladkiyan bahut samay lagati hain, shopping karne mein bahut time lagati hain, aapka agar man bhi ho to aap nahi karoge, does it happen ki yaar log kya bolenge ki main 2 ghante se bas taiyar hi ho raha hu? Even, you know, maybe at some time you do want to look good and you're trying to put an effort in the way you're looking, but you can't because log kya kahenge.
Maybe. So I'll tell, the way I see it, the process of thought behind how a guy gets ready and how a girl gets ready is very different. So if I know that 1 week down the line I have to attend an event, I will plan it today.
Okay.
And by evening I will be sorted ki mujhe ye ye pehenna hai. I know where this tie is. Mere cupboard ke kaun se, you know, isme kahan pe hai, under what shirt that tie is, and you know, under what bundle is that another shirt that I'm looking for, meko kya dhoke kab press karke rakhna chahiye. So this, all this planning will happen today itself. And then it'll unfold over the next 1 week where, you know, I know that that day is coming. So I think because of that, on the day when the event is, it doesn't take more than 5 to 10 minutes to get ready.
So it's more the operational excellence
It has to be very streamlined and very, very much ready for the occasion. Mm-hmm. You can't be running around thinking ki abhi main kya pehnu, you know, this that doesn't happen.
So that was Kartik with us having a very, very candid and an interesting chat. Thanks for joining us today. Please come back where we try to take you on another journey of another individual by they're trying to fit in. Thank you.